I wanted to say that back. And we've had some good times to connect over the years, and he wrote back, he goes, hey, this is a family affair. I want to come. I can't get there till late December 28th, but I want to come and be for the whole thing. Just, why did you respond that way? I mean, I know why, but yeah. Just...
Well, look, anyone that's going to be leading people into the presence of God 24/7 for 20 years, I just want to be around. And then when the Lord speaks to Mike and tells him about things, there's a trust I have in Mike. Because of his walk for the Lord, because of his reverence for the Word of God, I trust this man. As we fellowship, I go, he knows the Lord. And so when I see that the Lord is giving him a message and saying things are going to change, like something is happening right now, it's the same things that are stirring in my spirit. Like, we can't go on as is. So when I saw those videos of you talking about that, everything inside, it's almost like... okay, I'll just say it. But it's almost like that Mary and Elizabeth.
I love it.
You know, like something is leaping inside.
This is the first time I've ever been to an IHOP event. It's kind of crazy to me because I didn't know that much. And, you know, so I kind of went on the internet and started looking things up, and I go, man, there's a lot of great things going on here. And today was the first time I ever met Mike Bickle. And I love that guy. I do. I mean, you know, and Mike knows, we've talked about this, you know. There's people that told me not to hang out with him. Like, you know, words like creepy come up. And yet... I get to know this guy, and I'm going, man, I love his heart. And I just want to publicly say, I love Mike Bickle, you know?
Do we need Mike to introduce himself? Okay, he oversees the International House of Prayer. I think we've got that.
Yeah. All of the blogs on the internet about him are completely true. So
just go read any of them.
That's your introduction.
And you'll get your introduction.
Yeah, like one guy was so excited and we were meeting. He goes, I just love it. He goes, I wanted to hear all your stories. I'll go on the internet. I said, please don't.
The idea here is clear. People who say negative things on the internet are wrong because we say so. Listen to Francis Chan pound this message home.
I just want to speak to... This isn't IHOP. This is for other people who might be watching this. Because I know some of you have ditched Mike. And some of you ditched him because of something you think you might have heard someone say that may or may not be true.
How dare you?
And so you're going to ditch all of that. 50 years of prayer, teaching, you know, a lifestyle. And I thank God for a simple lifestyle. He could have made so much money and be living this lavish life, but he lived this way for all of those years. And you're going to ditch all of that and all the ridiculous stories because you heard something from a friend. I would say you are so foolish. And also, you better be careful because the Spirit of God dwells inside of him. You so easily depart from a son of God. I just can't do that.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. How sweet it is to be loved by you.
I need